Okay, process. Back in our content strategy work, we talked about our user story. And since that time, we've talked about our user story incessantly. But that's a good thing. We're validating our decisions around this build and the content itself based on that user story. But one of the secondary things we discussed earlier in the course was that people might have questions about what's involved. What's the process like? How does the team at Hayes Valley work? Will I have the guidance or the input I need to feel confident in picking this interior design firm? These are all fair questions. And the process page will cover the following. Hero section, consultation, and on-site review. These are the steps Rebecca gave us. Letter of agreement, design development, and construction adhesive, design, development, construction, install. Greemer, can we just dub it over with the correct title? Thank you, sir. Let's start with the hero section. And to do that, we want to first make a page. So from pages, we're going to press create new page. We'll call this one process, or even our process. We're going to hit enter to create the page. And that's it. That's our blank page. And for our hero section, we can drag in a section. And we actually already have a starting point here. It's called hero section. And that's it. That's our hero section. And we created a combo class for this, for portfolio. Had all the information we needed in there. And we can actually go in and duplicate that class. And what that's going to do is it's going to create a copy. And we can call that whatever we want. Maybe here we can call it process. Hit enter. And now any changes we make, they'll be based on hero section, just like our normal combo class would be based on hero section, the other one we created. But this process one will only affect process. So let's go down and choose a different hero image. Choose image. And something like this would look pretty good. We could change the color if we'd like. We can experiment with different colors throughout this process. But for right now, let's go to linear gradient, double click here, and change to, that doesn't look very good at all. That's okay for now. We can come back to this gradient later, but we have something to start with. And then after we do that, we might want to put in our other content. We have a heading, we'll drag that in. Let's look at our content strategy notes. For process, we have a hero section. The H1 says, learn about our process. And we can apply a class to that. We can apply a class, which is, I think it's major heading. That works. Secondary. Let's check to make sure that's the same one we applied to portfolio. Major heading, secondary. Okay, that's correct. So let's go back to our process. Learn about our process. Now we need our paragraph. Put a paragraph underneath this. That's okay, but we had something going on different over in portfolio. If we reference that, we can see we put hero paragraph, and that set a maximum width of 400 pixels. So let's go back to our process and set a maximum width of 400 pixels by applying hero paragraph. We're using as few classes as possible. That way, we don't have to make a change on every single instance of text throughout our site. We want to use classes to minimize the heavy lifting we have to go through in this process. We'll move the mouse off screen so we can copy some of our content to the clipboard. And we'll paste that right in here. That looks pretty good. Now, before we move on, we could add our navbar and our footer. So let's do that right now. We'll go to Add, Symbols. Let's grab the navbar, put that right inside the body element, and then we'll go back to Symbols and we'll drag our footer. We'll do that at the bottom of the page. We can drag it onto the canvas, or we can use the navigator for that. Let's use the canvas, and that works exactly as we'd expect. We're done with the hero section. Let's move on to our next step. This is the consultation and on-site review section. We're going to do something very similar. We'll drag in a section, but we're going to make a new class for this type. So we'll call this step section, since each section is going to have a different step of the process. And we can make a fixed height here, maybe 300 pixels. Actually, let's remove the height so that we can put content inside. Before we do any more styling, let's put some content inside the section. We'll put a heading. This will say consultation and on-site review. And let's add the class of major heading, actually secondary heading. That looks pretty good there. And with our section selected, we'll click step section right here. Let's add some padding. Let's do our 60 pixels on all side. That looks pretty good. The next thing we want to do is add which step this is. So we have four steps on the page. We'll create a step text block. We'll put that right above the heading. So let's grab a text block, put it above, and we'll type step one in this. Of course, we'll end up copying and pasting the section so we can be a little more specific with each. But step one is done. We could style this a little bit. Let's call this class step. And there are a number of things we could do here. We could choose Playfair display, maybe all caps. That doesn't look very good. Let's remove that capitalization. This could be fine for now. One thing to note is secondary heading has 10 pixels of margin on the top. We could add a combo class for this. We can call it less space. Could be a little more specific in the future, but less space works fine for now. Maybe 5 pixels of margin at the top. Let's actually try 0. It's a little bit closer. And to add a little more space, we could use a div block. Let's put a div block underneath consultation and on-site review. And we're going to do something unique here. Let's make the height 1 pixel. And let's make the width 50 pixels. So we can create almost a divider here. We'll choose a black color, but we'll drop the opacity on it pretty tremendously. So you can see right around 15, maybe 20%. We just have a very simple divider there. And we can add some margin on the top and bottom, holding down Option or Alt on PC. This is going to push the content away from it. So maybe 20 pixels or even 30 pixels on the top and bottom. Hitting Escape. That looks pretty good. Before we forget, let's grab that div block here and name it. We'll call it Horizontal Divider. And then let's add a paragraph. This is text we'll want to ask Rebecca for, but for now, this is a good starting point. Now, we could limit the width on this text. In fact, we could set limits to the heading, we could set limits to the step, but instead, let's use a div block to keep everything contained inside the section. So we'll grab a div block, we'll drag it above step one, and we'll just put the content inside. We'll use the navigator to make this a little bit easier, and we'll just throw everything in here. This is really lazy. Now, we could set limits. We could set a limit on the width of all of these elements. We could select the paragraph and set a maximum width there. We could do the same for the secondary heading, the step. We could do that over and over again. But one way to control a lot of elements like this at once is to wrap them with a div block. So that's a pretty straightforward way to control width on multiple elements. Let's drag a div block in, and we can just grab step, and all we're doing is dragging each of these elements inside div block. And a quick little shortcut here, if you click and drag just to the right, it'll place it underneath this parent item. So we're just grabbing paragraph, move it to the right. That's it. And now the div block has 4 children, step, secondary heading, horizontal divider, paragraph, and we can select that div block and we can call it step section container, although there are probably more specific, better names for this. And we can set the maximum width to something like 50%. Actually, we could just specify that the width is 50% or even 40%. That looks pretty good. So if we want to continue this trend, we could copy and paste. That's step one. This will be step two. Copy and paste again. That's step three. Paste again. That's step four. So let's go in and start replacing our text. This will be step two. This will be step three. This will be step four. Now remember, there's a lot of consistency in what we've created here, but each of these is using the same class. Because we copied and pasted the section, and because each of these sections contained the same elements with the same classes applied, if we change any one of these, like secondary heading, if we affect the padding on any one of them, we can see all of the others are affected. And that doesn't just occur on a page basis, just inside one page. It occurs throughout the project. So if we were using the secondary heading with less space applied, if we were using any class or any combo class on multiple pages and we changed one of them, it would affect every other instance of element with that class applied. So one thing to note here is these are H1s. We might want to make them H2, and that's a specification that is unique to each element. So if we had done this before copying and pasting, they would have all been H2s, but we can do that right now as well. Okay, each of them is an H2. Let's take every other section and align the content to the right. Now, there are a few ways to do this. We can use Flexbox, but because each of these is set to 40%, we have some issues if we use Flexbox. Let's demonstrate one way to do it using Flexbox. We could create align right, and we could use that that combo class on every other section, and we could just go to flex and move everything, justify it to the end. So we'd do the same thing here on step section, align right, and we kind of get that rhythm. But here's the problem. The left side and the right side, they're not even because each of these is 40%. We set a width of 40%, and that normally would work okay. By the way, this works if you set this to 50%, then they're quite even. You have that line, that consistency. But at 40%, there's something else to solve for, and that's the fact that this is not directly in the middle. It's a small detail, but it's one that might count. So instead of doing this, let's go back to that step section. Let's remove align right. Let's remove align right from this one as well. And instead, let's use grid. Now, each of these four has step section applied. So with any of them selected, since they're all using the same class, let's switch it to grid. And by default with grids, we get a 2x2, but we only want two columns and one row. So let's delete one of those rows, hit done, and now we have our grids here. But notice how the step section container is now a small part of this cell. It's because we set the width to 40%. Because this step section container is taking up 40% of its parent, that means it's now only taking up 40% of this specific cell. So we could raise this to 80, and that looks a lot closer to what we had before. Now, with every other one, we could just grab the step section container and move it over. Remember, things are automatically placed in the first available cell, so we can override this functionality. If we just try to drag step section container, it won't go anywhere. We can override with step section container selected. We can go over and set the position to manual. And now we can just drag it into the second cell. Same thing over here. This time, let's hold down shift because that will manually place an item. We can just drag it into the second cell. Now we have that alternating background. Now, we're in consultation and on-site review, so let's get this one perfected and move on to each of the subsequent sections. So, consultation and on-site review. With this one selected, let's choose a combo class that is consultation, and we'll set a background for this. The background can be anything we want, but we have one that looks almost like a blueprint, so let's use that. Can't really see it, so let's set it to cover, center. That looks a lot better now. One thing to note, this secondary heading, the contrast is a little bit lower, so we could go in and change dim gray to black. Again, this is only being used, the less space combo class is only being used on this page, so we're only affecting this page. Let's call that the end of consultation and on-site review and move to step two. Step two is letter of agreement. And we can do the same thing here. We can add a combo class, we can call it letter, and add a background image. This time we'll choose the image and something a little more like a letter. We have one right here. Here it is up in the top left. And we'll set the same thing, cover and center. It looks pretty good. That's letter of agreement. Let's move on to design development. Type in design development and we'll do the same thing. We're getting pretty good at this. Combo class, design development. And let's set a background image. We'll choose our image. We have this one right here. Let's do the same thing, cover and center. We're almost done. That's design development. Let's move on to construction adhesive, which is actually construction installation and design completion. Okay, and for this one, we'll do the same thing we did for the others and do construction. Let's add a background image, choose image, and we have one for construction that looks like this. Set it to cover, set it to center, and that's pretty good. Now, how is the height of each of these sections being defined? In other words, did we set a pixel value? Because if we go up here, the width, the height, all of these are blank. They're either automatic or none. So if we go into this and we add more content, let's just copy and paste a paragraph a few times. This section resizes. That's because the section is sized, as is any div block or section by default, by the content inside. So the content inside is defining this dimension. So if we scroll through, by the way, let's delete these extra paragraphs. If we scroll through, we can see they're basically using the same lorem ipsum text right now. But for instance, step four is a little bit longer because completion is on a second line. In other words, there can be slight changes to the way this text reflows, and the section is going to resize itself based on the content inside. That's a lot. We covered in a short time. We built out our hero section, the consultation section, agreement, design development, and the one with the long title. Up next, we'll make this page responsive.